into the Sonic developer session. Quite exciting.
Yeah, I'm the Hedgehog developer.
Oh yeah, childhood hero, baby. Some people have Hendrix. Some people have Martin Luther King. Me and GD.
Sonic the Hedgehog.
So if we can broadcast from inside, we will let you know. We will do so, but we very much doubt it. We've been stopped by the camera gorillas all morning trying to broadcast stuff. But we'll have a go.
Some of the ninja moves you can do. Obviously, you are best known for Sonic the Hedgehog, but before that game came out, what games did you work on first before Sonic?
Well, before Sonic, I made the Phantasy Star Online 2. And out of converted games, I made Space Harrier, Outrun, Ghost Ghost, Spy vs. Spy, and so on. But very first game I made was called Girls' Garden.
And a string of classics listed there from like way back in the day, but I mean, let's look at Sonic. Such a familiar character now, such an iconic character. But the original game made a great impact when it came out. But what was the idea? What did you want to achieve with your very first Sonic game? Where did the concept for it come from?
The game was Sonic's
Well, the original idea of Sonic came from a test program that I made. One day I thought about a new character which doesn't get blocked or stopped by enemies. In other words, a character which doesn't stop the progress of the game when encountering enemies. I then came up with a brief idea of character which used to be a rabbit, who rolls forward and tackles enemies and keeps running. He doesn't stop. And that later became Sonic.
Great stuff. And having achieved such success at Sega, how difficult was it for you then to leave and then set up a new studio? And are you enjoying the freedom, as it were, of running your own development studio?
Well, it was indeed a difficult decision to leave Sega. I really liked the company and enjoyed working there. And yes, I do enjoy working at my studio very much. One of the main reasons I left Sega was because I felt that I was getting a little bit distanced from the actual game making. But at my studio, I can really work with my own game, so this is exactly what I wanted.
Great stuff. We've got images behind us of the game, of your latest game over here, Kiwi. We also saw the trailer at the start. In your own words, can you tell us about the game?
Well, I think Kiwi is an action game set in a world of picture book. Its main character called Ivy, which is a little female Kiwi bird, who got separated from her mother. She cannot do much on her own, apart from keep running. And she cannot even climb a small gap by herself. So you, as a player for this game, is a sort of god, or the guardian, who helps Ivy to reach her goals by drawing vines on the picture book, which Ivy can run on it.
Sure. And given the nature of the game and the stretching and the moving and drawing of vines, was it obvious that it was always going to work on the DS and Wii, or did you consider other platforms first for it?
Well, Ivy the Cube was originally developed for Wii platform. We found out that the Wii's pointing device is quite ideal for this game, so we originally made a Wii version of this game. And we then decided that we could do the same thing on the DS using the touchpad. That's why we chose the this platform Wii and DS for this game.
Sure. Now, one thing that's puzzling me is it's not just simply Ivy the Kiwi, it's Ivy the Kiwi question mark. What's the question mark for?
I actually wanted you to be wondering why. When you complete games, you normally see ending movies and the stuff goes at the end. But when you complete Ivy the Kiwi, you will be able to read his picture at the end. Then you will find out why you see this question mark in the title when you complete this game. So please, try hard.
Oh, you big tease. That's, looking at Japanese gaming development, there's a lot of debate about the state of game development in Japan. Recently, Capcom's Inafune-san said that he sees that Japanese developers in general are 5 years behind their Western counterparts, and the games they're making just aren't good enough. I just wonder what your thoughts are on this.
Yes, you could say that Japanese game developers today are behind the Western competitors in terms of technology. But at the same time, Japanese developers can still come up with new game ideas and styles that are very much different from Western counterparts. And I also think that Japanese developers are catching up to the West in terms of technology too. So I do agree with Inafune-san's comment on Japanese games developers to some extent. The belief that Japanese games development has its own strong areas and to equally compete with Western counterparts.
Now, you're obviously no longer at Sega, but they continue to make Sonic games. I wonder what you think of the Sonic games now since you've left them.
そうですね、よくそのシリーズについてどのように評価されていますか。そうですね、よくその聞かれる質問なんですけど、実はあまり詳しく見ていないんですけども。
Well, since I left Sega, I don't really follow the series too closely. But I believe there are many more things that Sonic can do. So I'm very much looking forward to a future Sonic series. I believe in Sega and the Sonic team as well. So I'm sure that they will continue making fascinating Sonic series ahead.
Good stuff. I'm interested, of all the games you've ever made, do you have a personal favourite?
I've been involved in many games so far, but I must say it's still Sonic 1. That was a title which made me realise that I could do something to attract people around the world, so I must say it's Sonic 1 for me.
Retrogamers, set up by a movie. Yeah.